So I was recently asked about downloading third-party apps. Is it safe? Should typical Mac users be getting third-party apps? And in order to answer the question, I've made up four rules that you could follow when deciding to download a third-party app. The first rule is to ask yourself, do you really need the app? Because a lot of people just download apps just to try them out, just to see what they are, just because they're curious. But unfortunately, the way computer security is today, you really shouldn't be downloading apps unless you're sure that you need it. So ask yourself, is this something I can do without? Is this something that I can do with an existing app or some sort of built-in or Apple-produced app? And if the answer is you do need this third-party app, then you can proceed. And the next thing I would do, rule number two, is to look in the Mac App Store for it. If you can get an app in the Mac App Store, for typical Mac users, this is a lot safer. Apple has registered all the developers that are in the Mac App Store, and there's a little bit of responsibility there in terms of making sure the things in the Mac App Store are safe to download. So look for what you want. So for instance, say you want an app to do some graphic design, and you hear that Pixelmator is good. So you look up Pixelmator in the Mac App Store, and sure enough, there it is. You can purchase it in the Mac App Store, and that's the best place to get it. Even though a lot of times you can get it outside the Mac App Store, getting it in the Mac App Store for typical Mac users is your best bet. Now, rule number three is to only get apps that you trust. So how do you trust an app? Well, could be by reputation, or maybe you just have to do some research. So you can search for things like you can search for Pixelmator reviews or things like that. Just read about the app that you want. Try to get a good sense. Dig down even past the first page of results on Google. See what experts say. See what sites that you trust say about this app. You can reach out and ask other Mac users, other experts out there if you're unsure. Make sure that this is an app that you really want. You know, don't even bother with things like cleaners, things that promise to clean your Mac or keep your Mac more secure or all that. You don't need any of that stuff. You really just want to focus on apps that you need to get work done, to make your Mac more useful to you or enjoyable in terms of games and things like that. So make sure you trust the app. Then the fourth point is to think about where you're downloading the app and only download from official sites. So let's look at some examples. Here's some apps that we will not find in the Mac App Store, like Spotify. If you want to use the Spotify network instead of Apple Music, you could certainly download the Spotify app for your Mac. So if you search for Spotify download, notice that the first result comes up here at Spotify.com. And Spotify.com is the first few results here. And you can kind of really think about the fact that that's the official site for Spotify. But if you go and look further, you'll find other sites where they claim you can download the app, but they're not the official site. Don't ever download from some sort of third-party software download site. It's not a good idea. Here's another one. It's like, don't download from that. There's no reason to. Go directly to the actual site for that software. Only download from the actual site. Most of the time when I hear people getting in trouble with an app, it's because they downloaded it from some site that I've never even heard of, and they got the app, but maybe something else came with it. Something was bundled with it. Or worst case scenario is you don't actually get that app. You got something else, a piece of malware, because you weren't at the official site. So check to make sure. Ask an expert or do some research if you're not sure. And you know, when in doubt with any of these rules, just don't do it. Don't add an app. It's like letting somebody into your house when you install an app on your Mac. If you're not completely sure that that person should be there in your house, then you really should just lean towards safety and not let them in your house at all. It's the same thing for apps. Don't install an app unless you're absolutely sure and you follow these four rules before installing it.